go live slightly earlier. I'm hoping that there's a few friends about to join in and listen, and that you can hear everything that's going on. Give me a minute or two to get sorted. Inbox to the ready. John and Deanna are here. Wonderful. Great stuff. Hear me loud and clear, I hope. Wait for one or two people to gather just a minute. David Payne's here, of Mount Hawk. There's the, what was it, Sunday they were waiting a long time until I actually started. So apologies for that. But Now here we are again, another Thursday evening. Goodness me, don't they come around quickly? Is here. Well, being Conan Downs, of course. So, good to see a few faces. Good to know that you're there. So, I'm going to start this evening with number 15. I think you've got a list. I did pin that up. I'm going to start with 15, which is Praise the Lord, ye heavens, adore him. And I'm going to play it to the Redhead tune, the Flowersdale, the Redhead tune, which was written by Richard Redhead. So I'm going to play that tune this evening. I could do it to Austria, but let's do it to the Redhead tune. Yesterday I went and played the organ in Truro Methodist, and oh goodness gracious me, I've forgotten what I was missing in some respects. It's absolutely fine and it's great for practicing. I'm not short of an instrument on which to practice if I put my time into practice at all. But the sheer volume, I mean, I does play quietly as well, but I just built up from a few stops all the way through until it was, well, I didn't go any louder really. And despite having had a rest and been quiet for since lockdown, I forget the actual service, but when I used it for the last time and switched it off and then went back on Tuesday and checked that everything was definitely off, and it's been at rest and sprang into life yesterday without a moment's bother. So there's a lot of concern about pipe organs and how they should be used, and yes, it's good. It's like anything, if you leave it unused for ages, then it might well deteriorate, but ours hasn't as far as I can tell. I'm delighted about that. Moving on then to Father, hear the prayer we offer. 436, everything this evening is from hymns and psalms. 436, and I see we've got a choice of two tunes here. So we've got four verses. So perhaps I might go from one tune to the other. Why not? They're both in the same key, so it shouldn't be too difficult to go from one to the other. But watch out. So that anybody says, "Oh, I like that tune," then what I'll do is at the end of the second verse, I'll do something to get into the next tune, so that you remember what's what. So here's a play over for Father, hear the prayer we offer. So here's starting out with play over, two verses to Gott's will machen, and then two verses to Sussex, but I will put in a sort of bit of a link.
Thank you.
somebody can complain and say, what a strange thing to do, I suppose. But I blame the father, Lloyd, who played two tunes for Love Divine.
Now, I
mean, that was the other hymn. I'm going to do a couple of short ones in here tonight. Captain of Israel's host and guide of all who seek the land above. 62 is what I'm going to play next. It's only got a couple of verses, but it's one of those great hymns which sort of sticks in your mind. So I'll do a full verse play over. How about that? You've got a chance to draw breath. And let's see what we can do. Ah, that. Captain of Israel's host. Holy Spirit, 303, the tune written by Henry Smart, who was quite influential in the world of music, in particular in the world of organ building, and how the instruments developed at that particular time. It's a rich period in English organ building and how things developed and the various builders which were about. It would seem that as churches and chapels sprang up, there was a great demand for the organ. There's also a lot of controversy about it as well. You read some accounts. I'm glad that those who didn't want the organ didn't get their way. However, interesting period in history, to say the least. And Henry Smart was one of those people who and had quite an influence along with W.T. Best and so forth. Anyway, Holy Spirit ever dwelling in the glorious realms of light. Holy Spirit ever brooding on a world of gloom as night. So here we go. Here's a play over. Interesting, and that nowadays, that when I say interesting, nowadays, because of the advent of technology and how things have moved on from the old days of having to blow the organ by hand, and that's what my father had to do when he wanted to practice the organ. He had to pay somebody to come and blow it, not literally with a long kind of a pump in the handle. So honestly, we moved on from that onto rotary fans, and almost like an almighty great hair dryer. I think it's a good idea to stand in the way, because it generates such a wind to power all the pipes. But nowadays, there's a lot more computer technology inside the console. It doesn't usually make a sound as such. But you can have some compromises, but the control of the organ, I think I mentioned once or twice about the buttons I can push, so I can get pre-selected combinations, and I can control the stops easily, and I've even got in the blink of the eye, I always think with a computer, you know, you can make lots of mistakes with a touch of a pen or whatever. As organs have grown sort of more complex and you can program up and all the rest of it, that's fine. So it's quite possible to program up a whole recital program and just keep stabbing a button for your next registration. That's fine until the whole thing throws a bit of a glitch or somebody comes in and changes all your combinations. We've had that happen just once at Shura Methodist. I wasn't actually there, but it's programmed. One is very, very quiet, two's a little bit more, just like this is, right? Two's a bit louder. Spending 3 hours programming up all your program, having registered it all, and when you come and you start and you push the first button, you think that doesn't look right, and the second button doesn't look right, and so on and so on. It's almost like doing a big essay, writing it all out by hand, and then somebody going and throwing a glass of water over it. Anyway, I digress. So we're on to another short hymn now, 277. This is the God we adore, and I'm pretty sure I've played it before, but it's one of those great hymns, isn't it, of the Christian Church, which sums up so much about our faith. So this is the God we adore, 277. From the original installation, but nevertheless it's still Brindley and Foster. Never ceases to amaze me that these instruments have stood the test of time for years and years and years and just go on. They're bespoke products and they just go on. They can be recycled. Nobody's going to recycle TMC whilst I'm about, but you can use bits of them again. They can go on. I know I've been in situations whereby we've taken down an organ, which seemed such a shame because the church didn't want it anymore, and we've kept the best bits of it, the best bits of it and use them somewhere else, especially the pipe work. And when you think of all the work that goes into making pipes and things, it's quite something. It really is. Craftsman's art and music's measure, all my pleasure all combined. There we go. Anyway, to our last hymn for this evening, 308. O breath of God, breathe on us now. Once again, still thinking of the Pentecost idea and the Holy Spirit. I have quite a few stories about various things that have happened when I've gone to play for weddings and things, when you get the occasional little sort of hiccup with something. I'll just relate one to you briefly. I went to Port Leven to play for a wedding service, and I dutifully played a bit beforehand. I took my hands off, and a note continued. In the trade, we call it a cipher. And I thought, well, I'm not going to be able to play the rest of the service with this note stuck on. Hardly play. That note stuck on all the time. So, having had some experience of being inside organs and working with Lance Foy when I was a student, I thought, I'll go in and fix this. But hope to fix it. So I managed to get inside the instrument with the aid of a knife to act as a screwdriver to undo some panels. I had to move some stuff out of the way. Got in there, and could I find this wretched note? Had an idea where it might be, and it's a veritable forest inside. I was standing. Could I find this note that was going on? I'm getting slightly frustrated with this going on. It gets on your nerves after a while, doesn't it? And I put my hand on a piece of wood, fixture to fit in, to think that it would pull myself up to reach what I thought was the offending point. And at that time I was slightly heavier, shall we say. Well, perhaps not, but anyway, obviously it wasn't enough to support my weight, and I managed to pull some bits over, and I fell and banged the head on the small box and all sorts of things. Did it eventually find the aforementioned pipe, but by this time I'd stopped that, and by this time I was in a hot lather and sweat, and dusted myself off down a bit, and got on and played the wedding, and then afterwards I thought, well, I better repair the damage I'd done. Fortunately, there was no significant damage of any description. I was able to put things back. I did own up to the fact that this had happened. I feel sure I did that. But there we go. So these things happen. You never know quite what might happen. But on with the hymn. Breathe, breath of God, breathe on us now. To the tune Calm by J.B. Dykes. So let's go off for something again. Here's a playover. Thank you. Sunday evening. As always, keep your requests coming. I've advertised various things on the internet before. Don't forget Gareth, lovely one this week with him playing Gareth Moore from the Isle of Man, playing the harmonium this week. That was just fabulous. And various organ recitals and things going on Sunday at 5 o'clock. A chap called Richard McVeigh does approximately 2.5 hours of him singing. I think I mentioned that before, and you can actually message him to get your hymn played, so he does everything off the cuff. And at 6 o'clock, the Royal School of Church Music is doing a big Sunday service sing. And I've been trying to do a little bit of preparation with folks around the county. I'm trying to get to grips with some of the notes. But lots of things to look in. You can look in on it. And then I'll be here at 8 with a few more people to rest. So stay well, keep safe, and good night, and God bless.